Olive may not be your average dog.
What?
But when Santa needs help...
Oh, no!
She just might become the most extraordinary reindeer ever.
I heard Santa on the radio saying that he needed Olive, the other reindeer.
You're not a reindeer. You can't fly.
You wait and see.
Olive! Olive! Olive!
Olive, the other reindeer, coming to save Christmas. Tonight at 8, 7 Central, right here on Nickelodeon.
Boy, if you think plain voice Chris Pratt voicing Mario was a crime, you must be new here. They've been doing this shit for a long time. Why? A-listers sell.
Like, for instance, you wouldn't buy Trick or Treat out of the dollar DVD bin because you happen to like Skippy from Family Ties. You bought the DVD because you saw Gene Simmons and Ozzy Osbourne, even though their cameos were relatively short in the movie.
Olive, the other reindeer, aired on December 17, 1999, being the child of Simpsons and Futurama creator Matt Groening, the latter being what preceded Olive on the premiere date, under the production company The Curiosity Company, and animated by DNA Productions, whose only notable work at this point was animation for The Weird Al Show. Because his major title, Jimmy Neutron Boy Genius, was just a 1998 TV pilot and wouldn't be a major cartoon mainstay until 2002, after his feature film in 2001.
Hi, I'm Paul.
The film was based on a book by Vivian Walsh and a play on words on a lyric from the classic Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer song, specifically, All of the Other Reindeer. The main title character, a Jack Russell Terrier that's rather well-behaved for a small dog breed, was voiced by Drew Barrymore, in between her roles on Never Been Kissed and a much bigger regret, Titan A.E. She'd be chased by a dumbass postman, voiced by Homer Simpson himself, Dan Castellaneta, helped by a penguin, voiced by the fugitive's Joe Pantoliano, disappointing her owner, voiced by comedian Jay Moore, and be under the influence of her pet Flea, voiced by Peter McNichol, who was one of the annoying camp organizers in Addams Family Values. With an interesting cameo by R.E.M. frontman Michael Stipe, let's see how we make a dog fly to help Santa deliver on Christmas and avoid a postal worker going postal and interfering with it.
Let's check out Olive, the other reindeer.
And Drew Barrymore's in this too.
This
for
was up.
Acting crew wins summit.
This was also made by the same guy who brought us The Simpsons and Futurama.
Yay, Matt Groening. I'm growing old of this.
Look at that 3D. Wasn't this made in like the early 2000s or something?
1999.
Yep, that's why it's shit. I love Valentine's. This Day. Looks really best source filmmaker. Every day special. I'm not
complaining, but I'm always counting the days. She is so flat.
The characters are essentially flat.
No, I mean flat as in...
I get it.
Yeah, flat as in singing. Here you go. All that wonderful tiny smell and no needles to back him up. Wow.
Well, it works for them.
Yay.
There's a grumpy postman.
Who wants to be a dog catcher? A hard-working entrepreneur. Smuggling in
junk food. Dirty magazines. Files hidden inside dirty magazines. Zootopia prediction?
Nah.
Furry prediction.
The furries were started like way, way, way back. It just came into prominence in the 80s and the 90s.
Furries were sexually awakened though when they saw Crystal Fox from Star Fox Adventures. Martini. I sell dirty magazines and I'm named after a drink.
He sounds like a good time.
How are your dog chores coming? Did you bury any bones today? No, Tim. Chase any cars or cats?
Afraid not.
Did you even make a token attempt to tear up any flower beds?
Uh-uh.
And I haven't heard any senseless barking.
That's the best dog ever and you want it to behave bad?
You know, when I was a kid, I tried my best to, like, look for this because I thought it was an actual series. That way I could have some context for that scene.
That flea scares me. I don't know why.
He looks creepy and he has derp eyes. And plus it's a bug.
This is where the identification of people feeling like they shouldn't be. I sexually identify as a reindeer.
By the way, people draw me as a reindeer.
You sexually identify as a reindeer, Sappy.
I sexually identify as another reindeer. I want to squish him. I want him to die a very painful death.
I'll get the rubbing alcohol.
No, get all the torture devices. Get all the bug zappers and bug spray.
What?
Everything.
Less water.
Get the friggin' front line! It must die. Christmas, bug and hum. It sounds like he's saying, like, bah, fucking hum.
Me too, I thought that.
Isn't he played by, Dan Castellaneta?
Let's check it.
I don't know.
Dan Castellaneta was the postman. Fucking hell, why is this guy complaining about this shit? Santa's lightening his fucking load. If Santa cancels Christmas, the strain would go even more towards the fucking postal service.
Yeah, really, especially with nowadays with the online shop things.
There's also fucking other parcel delivery services.
I need a ticket to the North Pole. Bus N34 connects at Arctic Junction boarding right now. I'll take one ticket, please.
Make that two tickets. Hi, old buddy. Can you pay for my ticket?
No, Martini. Why don't you go pursue other opportunities?
Come on, I'll pay you back later. It's Christmas.
No, you won't.
There's no room at the inn. Please.
What a mooch.
This is absolutely the last time I help you out.
Okay.
Let me go!
This dog committed mail fraud. I'm taking her into custody.
Mail fraud, Olive? Cool. Well, see you around.
What's all this about?
She's wanted for several counts of mail fraud, including licking the self-adhesive stamps and not mailing early for the holidays.
What? What?
Those are illegitimate fraud.
Are you serious?
I'll root for you on court TV.
Ah!
Help me, Martini!
Judge Judy! Hands! Oh, the pants! No!
Could have easily avoided them, though.
Come on!
Oh, come on! She paid for your friggin' ticket! She don't owe you shit!
To the North Pole.
Blitzen's hurt, so they need another reindeer or they can't fly. I heard Santa on the radio saying that he needed Olive, the other reindeer.
I sexually identify as a reindeer.
His head looks like a fucking dolphin.
Every fucking human head looks like a dolphin piece of whatever. I don't know.
Well, our Martini is also voiced by another notable person, Joe Pantoliano.
I have no idea who the fuck that is.
He's known as Cosmo from The Fugitive.
I thought you were going to say Cosmo from The Fairly Odd Parents. It's like, huh?
Oh, Cosmo Rampo, The Fugitive, 1993 movie with Harrison Ford. Are you going to the North
Pole? Never heard of it.
What about The Matrix? He was Cypher in 1999.
Never seen it. A silver cool dies inside because there's yet another movie I haven't seen.
Fucking hell, what's he doing? He's still got packages to deliver! And mail!
That can't happen.
That's gotta hurt like a bitch. Just fucking give up! If Christmas is canceled, you'll be having to deliver more and break your back.
Flaw?
You literally had to cross-dress to catch a goddamn dog.
You're not even dog catcher. From the North Pole and saving Christmas.
This guy's logic is fucked. Christmas is canceled! Nothing like No, his flight is canceled. That means he's gonna have to start shipping fucking first class and express priority. Jews as Maskina?
Hey, don't tamper with the mail. It's a federal offense.
To Olive from Deus Ex Machina. Oh my gosh.
Postal regulations require you to stay put and keep quiet.
You still have fucking earrings. You also deviated from your route by about 3,000 miles.
I never understood that joke. Deus Machina.
Deus Ex Machina, it's like a way to get out of the situation in a bullshit way. Like how in My Little Pony all the rainbow magic stuff is the Deus Ex Machina.
El Tormento.
I still don't like the human designs.
Icicles must be surrendered at door.
Is that a BDSM thing with bells on it?
I don't know.
Barking reindeer, isn't that just
stow it, Tendra Breath? Oh, savage. When you're
this far and another musical number.
No,
sounds like he's from Police. Life's hard enough, and now Santa's
flight. It's been an awful day. Sounds like an REM song. We're not so bad, except for that bunny.
What? Never trust the bunny.
I wonder if there's a casino. Yeah, there's a casino on the North Pole. But Santa said on the radio that he was counting on Olive, the other all reindeer. Of the other reindeer, not Olive. Dang that.
She knew it. The friggin' flea convinced her otherwise. It's not her fault. Don't
you even care? Oh, I'm sorry. It's not her fault that she's a retarded mutt. No!
I feel bad for laughing.
But it's funny. It's like, but I no.
I think that helps even more retarded than Olive. I'm just saying.
I sexually identify as a reindeer.
Oh god. I just learned that you'd better not pout. Oh god, what the fuck is wrong with her face? I'm telling you
why. Everything is wrong with every single friggin' human character on this friggin' TV special.
If they have like high fucking security, then where the fuck are like, you know, the FBI elves? Secret Service elves. Got 13 channels of shit on the TV to choose from. That dog
is dead
by the time the shift, but the thing is over. You are a fucking little dick! I goddamn hate that flea!
Everybody hates this flea.
Here we go. The train set that should have been mine when I was a kid. That was the year Santa started putting me on his naughty list. He didn't cut me any slack, so I'm not cutting him any slack. Oh,
gee, I wonder why.
You must have been molested as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Of not abusive parents.
Baby. The postman. I knew it. Knew it. Let's go. But where?
Just head north. Sooner or later, I'll pick up the scent. Yeah, just follow a scent. Go on there, Lassie. The little Timmy fell down the fucking well. What the fuck, Timmy? Oh, I can smell Timmy.
Well, she's still a dog biologically.
Yeah, biologically she's a dog, but sexually she identifies as a fucking reindeer. What is she gonna be, a flying nose? Hello, creep. That's fucking creepy.
Olive is pissed!
Heart attack in a box!
And then they crashed and burned.
And everybody died, the end. No airbags?! That's not safe.
They weren't designed for that fast to travel. Normally, post vans go a little slow.
The song's just no. Yeah, their voices sound nice, but the lyrics are just blech.
London! Rolex!
Triple X!
Oh, baby!
Sydney!
Oh baby, oh baby, oh baby. When are we going to Japan?
Rome!
The Eve country!
Rome!
Oh, the Pope!
Gee, I wonder what he got.
He got a Packers hat!
Ireland! India!
Japan land?
Where's America? We're America!
It was at the start.
Tokyo! Where's all the animals?
We're visiting Japan land.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Godzilla the monster!
Godzilla the Ultraman!
Harry, wee wee!
Wee wee!
Oh, Quasimodo!
Hey, buddy!
A bass crasher!
Well, I gotta hand it to you, Olive. You saved
Christmas. No.
Oh, by the way, your German cousin Schnitzel says hi.
With the BDSM bell jingle outfit. He's secretly gay.
That was crack.
Merry shit scram!
Well, on Bart's side, now you don't have to do your job anymore.
Now you sexually identify as a penguin?
Fish.
Fish.
This movie was a lot better when I was younger.
Yeah.
Now it's like a piece of shit on a glamorous turd.
Uh-huh. I don't like the art style. That's my only complaint, and the songs are not good.
Yeah, I agree.
A lot of the animation.
It's a lazy animation for a cashin. But the humor was good.
Oh yeah, I thought they had a nice adult humor in it. I just think they could have gone farther.
Especially the friggin' Deus Ex Machina. That killed me, because I didn't think that was a thing back in the early or late 90s. I forget when.
Be the victim
all your life.